Consider two grapes. One grape has hydration, moist and plump. The other one is dry, without any hydration, turning into a dry little raisin. How not to raisin, coming up. As you know, Asian don't raisin. And for that reason, I might have a thing or two to teach you about hydration. Hi guys, it's Jules, and in today's video, this is part two of our three series. In the last video, I explored drugstore cleansers. In today's video, we're going to be covering drugstore moisturizers. Stay tuned. We need to hydrate, hydrate, hydrate. I cannot overstate the importance of this step in one's skincare. We definitely need to make sure that we pick the right moisturizer in order to really control the right levels of hydration in our skin. Over time, you can really slow the process of dry skin and therefore aging. There are so many moisturizers. The drugstore is a good starting point for accessible as well as affordable. I'm gonna go through my choices for moisturizers for different skin types so that I can help you figure out what might be best for your skin. Today, we're only gonna cover drugstore. If you would like me to cover more high-end moisturizers, that probably needs another video at least. So I can definitely do that for you. Please let me know if you're interested and please subscribe for future videos. So for skincare, the ingredient deck is so important. I highly suggest you educate yourself on some of the key and core ingredients that go into some of your skincare, but I also will link three websites below in the description box for you so that you can further research those ingredients and find out more about them. So if you haven't seen that cleanser video, please go check it out because I do go into more depth about the ingredients and figuring out which ingredients are good and which ingredients are not so good and what type of products contain those ingredients so that you can figure out what is optimum for your skin type. So some of the same principles apply to moisturizers, and you're basically going to be looking for good moisturizing ingredients. These ingredients include ceramides, glycerin, as well as dimethicone. These are all highly moisturizing, and there's a lot of research behind what they can do to hold moisture into your skin barrier. The aim is always to try and find products that are low, if not completely absent, of fragrance, as well as parabens, as well as unnecessary chemicals that don't aid in the hydration of our skin. These products are pretty good. They are mostly absent of those bad ingredients, and they have a lot of nourishing ingredients for most skin types. The thing that's important to understand is that your skin is the largest organ on your body, and it is a living membrane, so it's meant to keep things out and keep things in. So you want to keep it supple and responsive to your environment, and also you want to try and really manage those hydration levels so that it can work in an optimum fashion. Part of understanding that is really understanding and knowing one's own skin type and one's own sensitivities when it comes to certain ingredients and how your particular skin works with those products. If you don't already know, below in the description box, I will link a Healthline article. It has some techniques for you to figure out what skin type you are. A couple of dermatologists that upload skincare videos here on YouTube are very helpful as well. Dr. Dre, as well as Dr. Vanita Rattan. She is more focused on skincare for darker skin tones. Really good resources, figure out your skin type as well as the best ways to care for it. I will link all of that in the description box below. If you have skin, then you've lived with some of the things that you have to deal with. When your skin deals with something it really loves, it like just drinks it up and it really looks better and it feels better. We've also dealt with ingredients or skincare products that our skin does not receive very well. Our skin will tell us it will be a lot drier, a lot tighter, or we will have a reaction or a rash. Our skin will generally be a good guy. It is really important to change only one skincare item at a time so that you can really keep track of your skin. Your skin will let you know if it likes something or not. You just need to pay attention and you just need to really follow through and watch the condition of your skin after you've introduced something new and see how your skin is reacting, good or bad. We are going to start with moisturizers for dry and dehydrated skin. Then we're going to move to normal/combination skin, and then we're going to end off with oily slash acne prone skin. We're gonna get to the products now. I'm going to link everything in the description box below. I should also tell you what skin type I am. I am 49 years old and I have a very oily skin type. I dealt with acne for a very long period of my life and now I'm dealing with aging skin, still occasionally acts a little bit acne prone. So it is a little bit on the sensitive side, but it is very oily. So I know how to deal with a little bit of everything. When I go through these products, I want you to keep in mind that these creams are all ones that I've tried. You'll be getting my anecdotal experience on who I think this product would be ideal for. Obviously, you're gonna try and you're gonna test and see optimally whether it works for your personal skin type. We're gonna start off with a workhorse. This is a really great moisturizer. My entire family uses it and it is both good for face and body. It is a very simple, it's CeraVe, it's a moisturizing cream. This one is thick and creamy. It will glide on very easily and absorb in a reasonable amount of time. I use this at night. It is a little bit too thick during the day, but if you have a dry skin type, your skin will drink this up. It will love it. This has a lot of really good simple ingredients, ceramides as well as glycerin and a lot of other moisturizing factors. This is a really good one if your skin is very reactive. There are not a lot of offending ingredients in this one. This one is a really good one. The next ones I have are a little bit more of a higher end at the drugstore, but these ones are also very effective as well. So this is the La Roche-Posay line. I showed you some of the cleansers in my last video. This is the Lipikar Balm. This is the AP Plus. Sometimes dry skin can be itchy skin, and this one is an anti-itch and it is very, very soothing. It is a lipid replenishing soothing balm. Sometimes when your skin is dry, it is itchy and reactive, this will calm it right down. And then these two are more your hybrids. These are definitely for dry skin, but I also can use this. These two are the Tolerain Ultra Cream and the Hydrophase UV. This one has an SPF 30 in it. Both of these work even for my skin type. They're not as thick as the other two, but they work really well for dry skin as well. So this is the brother to the CeraVe cream. This one is the moisturizing lotion. This is good for almost everybody. It says on it, it's for normal to dry skin, which it is definitely good for normal to combination, as well as slightly dry. I don't know if you'll love this if you have extremely dry skin, but this is Miss Congeniality. This will work for a lot of different people. When my skin is even as slightly on the drier side, I will reach for this as well. So another all-rounder, this one is very similar to this one, but it is by Cetaphil. I covered the cleanser in the last video. This one I think is a less offending product than the cleanser. There is less offending ingredients in this one and I think it will work. It does say on it, it's for all skin types. So very much like this one, depending on how your skin is feeling, these two will work very well for a lot of different skin types. So these last two that I have in the normal category also on the label describe themselves for normal skin. These are fantastic. I love these two. One is the facial moisturizing lotion with SPF 30. This is the daytime moisturizer. And this one is the facial moisturizing lotion. This one is for the PM. This is for your nighttime routine. This does not contain SPF. These two are my two favorite. Even though I am an oilier skin type, my skin tolerates these well. They are just thick enough that they feel moisturizing without really sitting on the skin. They sink in pretty quickly. Even this one with the sunscreen, they will be well received by mostly everybody. These two are very popular. A lot of people like them. And sometimes something is popular for a reason. These are great. For oily as well as acne prone skin, I'm talking acne prone, not actual acne skin. That is a whole series I will need to cover at a later date. If you're interested in that, please let me know. I really have a lot to share about acne as well as aging. That is something that we can definitely cover in a future video. This one is the Neutrogena Moisture Oil Free. This one is for sensitive skin. There is also one for combination skin. I do like this one, but just note that this one goes on and it does not sink in right away. So if you do like this one, you're gonna have to give it a bit more time to sink in. And I wouldn't really suggest it under makeup because your skin does not fully absorb this one quite as well as some of the others. And then this one, This one, let's talk about, because I know there's some controversy about this one. This one is the Neutrogena Hydro Boost. This version is the gel cream for very dry skin, but I take offense to that. I don't think this is for very dry skin. I'm gonna show it to you guys. It is a very jelly-like consistency. It is a gel cream, perfect way to describe it. It is gel cream, sinks in pretty quickly, and it's pretty lightweight and pretty cooling. And yes, it holds moisture, but for very dry skin types, I don't think this is going to be occlusive enough. I don't think this is gonna hold the water in. I know they market it towards that, but for me, I think that this is more, believe it or not, for normal to oily skin type. Who I think this is for are slightly dry or normal and even slightly oily skin type. This version is the fragrance-free version. This is the one you're gonna wanna buy, not the other one that's for dry skin that has fragrance, because that one is quite perfumed and I find the smell quite strong, and a lot of people have trouble using it for the fragrance. And then these last two also we should talk about, because these two are a bit of a specialty moisturizer. These ones are the CeraVe. These are the Renewing SA Lotion and the Renewing SA Cream. The reason why I wanted to talk about these are they are fantastic, but I think you need to recognize what they are. SA stands for salicylic acid. It is a chemical that cleans out the pores of your skin and helps it turn over. They market this as for extremely dry, rough, and bumpy skin, who I think this product is for. I don't think this is for very dry skin sensitive types. I think this is for people who have really rough, bumpy skin. If you have conditions like keratosis, which is really a bumpy, rough, orange peel-like skin, this is going to work wonders. This is a little tip that I have. When I was going through some rough acne patches, and even now, if I feel some acne coming on, CeraVe has the cleanser. I will use that as well as this in my routine. It works really well to clean out the pores on acne prone skin. And that is something that I think you have to try out to see for yourself if it works. But for me, it has been a game changer. I really love doing skincare videos for you guys. If you've tried any of these products, let me know what your holy grails are from the drugstore. I would really love for you guys to share and care and let me know in the comment section below. If this was helpful and you enjoyed that, please subscribe and hit that notification bell for the third part of the series on sunscreens, as well as a lot more skincare videos to come. Hit the like button, share with your friends, and I'll see you next time. So Charles, I think that it's really important you moisturize. I think a good choice for you, Charlie, would be the moisturizer with SPF. What do you think? Should we try it? No! That's probably not good.